seduction down that aisle. She is ready. Chris, go ahead and open your left arm. It's your beautiful bride. And both of you may step forward just underneath here. Perfect. And all of the guests may be seated. Take a deep breath, Mark. Congratulations. As you know, you are here today to be joined together in marriage. And this is an act as ancient as the history of the human race. But it's still as new as each morning. And it speaks of the past and the future, the life of the individual and the existence of the community. Now, in presenting yourselves here today, you both are performing an act of faith, really, in each other. A faith that shall grow and mature and endure. What if you should have your love set on such faith? Not just for this moment, but in all the days ahead. I want you to ever cherish the hopes and the dreams that you now hold. And I want you to stand fast in hope and confidence, believing in yourselves. But most importantly, believing in each other. In this spirit, you will create a partnership which will radiate to one another and give new hope and strength for any and all who see it. Now, if the two of you both wish to be united into this estate, will you please turn and face each other? And go ahead and pass your flowers out for me if you don't mind, Katie. While holding on to your loved one's hands, and looking into each other's eyes, Chris, I ask you the most important question of the day. Do you take this beautiful woman to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
And likewise, Katie, do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
And now to seal this pledge, we proceed with the exchanging of vows. Chris, you'll be first. If you can please repeat after me. I, Chris, take you, Katie.
I, Chris, take you, Katie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I vow to love.
I vow to love.
To honor.
To honor.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
Completely and forever.
Completely and forever.
And Katie, will you please repeat after me? I, Katie, take you, Chris.
I, Katie, take you, Chris.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
Promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I vow to love.
I vow to love.
To honor.
To honor.
And to cherish you.
And to cherish you.
Completely and forever.
Completely and forever.
And now may I have the rings, please? Now, rings have naturally come to symbolize eternal love within the union of mind and body and spirit. And so, yes, circles, these rings have no beginning and no end. And that symbolizes the continuation of true love, an endless love that you both will always share. But also, these rings are made of precious metals, and like your love, never fade. They will never tarnish. May these rings be a symbol of the promise that you both are making to one another, as well as a reminder of your mutual devotion. A love much like these rings. It's complete and beautiful and endless. Please retake this ring. Place it onto your bride's left hand. Vegas weather.
Yes.
Doing it.
That's good.
Okay.
While holding the ring there on her finger and looking into her eyes, I ask that you repeat after me once more. With this ring,
with this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Will you take this ring?
Yes.
Place it onto your groom's left hand. Jam it on there good.
It's on there.
While holding the ring there on his finger and looking into his eyes, I ask that you repeat after me as well. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And now, we both join each other behind the candles that are lit upon the table. Here, Chris, would you walk in first? It's easier with her shoes and dress. Walk in there, and can you go ahead and follow him next to you? And I want you to go ahead and stand close to each other, and go ahead and turn and face each other. Get close. Pretend like you like each other. I want you to take this moment and think back. Try to remember the very first time when you both met. See, these wonderful memories, they will last you forever, and they mean the most. And they brought you here to this very spot. And these candles have both been lit to represent your lives as individuals to this very moment. And they are two distinct lights. They're each capable of going their own separate ways, but today there must be a uniting of these two lights into one. So at the same time, you each carefully take your own candle. And I want you to light the center candle together, thus symbolizing your two lives joining into one flesh. When that's done, go ahead and turn away from each other and blow out your own candle. Now this one light can never be divided. Just as your lives now shall never be divided. May this one light radiate and continue to be a witness of your unity together. Join each other once again. Watch your step. You know the rules. Well, you two, if there's anything that you remember of this moment, just always remember that it was love that brought you both together today. And it is only love which shall make it a glorious union. By love in which your commitment shall endure. And you now have what remains the most honorable title which may exist between a loving couple. And that's the title of living as one. And finally, out of all of the hosts on earth, these two have come and have looked into each other's faces. And they've seen their uniqueness, their oneness. May you live faithfully together, performing the vow and covenant made between you. And may you ever remain in sympathy and understanding, living according to the ways of truth and beauty and love. You're beautiful too. Thank you. Will everyone now please rise? You know it's coming. Chris and Katie, and as much as you both have consented together in marriage today and have witnessed this consent before this company, you have each pledged your faith one to the other and have sealed this pledge with the exchanging of rings. And by the authority vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor to pronounce you as husband and wife. And Chris, you may kiss your wife. Don't be too shy now. You're married now. Tell you what, I'm going to have you guys step forward on a flatter surface. And now I invite you to both start in your first hand. Come along. The sky's above.
Introducing to the world for the very first time, Mr.